several fall planters recently, but I had one more design idea in me. I wanted to show it to you. And I think what I love so much about this one is that the style of it reminded me of what a lot of you already have sitting on your dining room table anyway, and that is a dough bowl. Do you guys see the design of this planter? If you don't already have a dough bowl, they have this one available at Stokely, which is where I am right now. But if you do have a dough bowl at home, you can use that as the base for this arrangement. Whether you're inside or you're outside, you know, so many of us are trying to social distance for this holiday season. And if you're gonna have your guests outside for Thanksgiving, then you can do this arrangement out there too. It can go indoors or outdoors. So I wanted to show you the basic elements and the principles that we've done here so you can repeat it in your own home. And guys, you guys know, we use the same design principles no matter what we're doing, if it's planting in a planting bed or if we're doing a tabletop arrangement. We've got odd numbers of plants. So we've got three different types of plants, odd numbers. We've got our fern that we put on either side, a low fern. We've got our variegated ivy, English ivy here. And then we have this burgundy color sweet potato vine. I love this dark purple color for the fall. I think a lot of times we think orange and yellow and red and like super bright colors, but I really like this muted tone because they serve as a backdrop for the pops of orange and different things with the gourds and the pumpkins. And then once our Thanksgiving celebration is over, we can pop these out and we can put ornaments, like some big Christmas ornaments in here. And so you're only spending this money one time to do this arrangement, and then you're putting additions to it and getting multiple uses out of it, which I love. You guys know I love that so much. So then once that's all said and done, you can use all of these in your spring planters, take them outside and create a third arrangement out of the exact same plants. So if you guys have any questions about this arrangement, be sure to comment below. I'm happy to help you guys with anything you need in this project. Oh, and I forgot one more thing. Don't forget the Spanish moss. This is what really makes it look like it's a complete project. I've literally just stuck these planters in here. I have not planted them. Put the pots on top and tucked with Spanish moss. Done. Anybody can do it. You guys got this. Send me some comments if you have any questions.